All right, first question up for this week is about squatting technique. So obviously we've got a video here where we're watching a lifter squat. Now, I'm gonna skip ahead just a little bit because this is a set of seven and the first couple reps look fine. But as you can see later on, you start to see this chest fall pattern take place. Now we've talked about this before. It's when you start coming up out of the hole, your knees go back and your hips go up. So what we see is that your back angle increases. So if I can, I'm going to try to stop this in the bottom, which I always have limited success with. So if we look at your back angle here, as we see when you start to come up, your back angle is going to increase, meaning that you're going to get more horizontal. It's going to turn a little bit more into a good morning, for lack of a better term. So watch. See, so we call that a chest fall pattern, okay? And it's really the most common deficiency that you see in squatting. If you're gonna have a movement pattern deficiency, which you will once the weight gets heavy enough, then this is the one to choose. The reason is that the squat trains the legs, and in this scenario, your legs are the limiting factor. So strengthening your legs helps this improve, as well as just being aware of it. So let's talk a little bit about fixes and where should you go from here. I made a post on Facebook yesterday talking about the 80% technique heuristic. And I've talked about it on other guided programming calls. I've talked about it on our YouTube channel from time to time. The gist of it is this. That if you've got one or two minor technical deviations, then you're in the good enough category, and what you need to spend your time on is focusing on getting strong. Of course, try to fix it, but the focus for you is getting stronger. If you've got a whole bunch of minor technical deviations or some major technical deviations, then the focus for you has to change and it has to be on fixing your technique first. So I don't want to go into a lot of detail and take us too far off track, but suffice to say that this video here is definitely above the line. You're definitely over that 80% perfect technique threshold. It's only a minor deviation that happens when the RPE gets high enough. So things for you to do to correct this. One, when you're training your competition lift, be aware of it and try to fight against it. Fight to keep your chest up. Fight to keep your position. And when you're doing your assistance exercises, you want to favor things like pin squats are going to be really good for you, safety bar squats, and high bar squats. Although you don't squat well, I suppose you squat with a low bar position. It's not crazy low, but it's low, so high bar squats might be something worth trying. Additionally, if you've got the movement proficiency to train front squats heavy enough, then front squats can help you as well, but that's going to fall more into the supplemental category. And for your supplemental category, really anything that trains your quads is going to be useful. So single leg work, leg press, hack squat, belt squats, just kind of whatever you've got that trains quads directly. You want to keep working those quads and try to make your quads as strong as possible. So the good news for you is that this is all pretty much built into your program. So you shouldn't have a lot of programming modifications that need to be made. And keep in mind that you are above that technical threshold, so I want your focus to continue to be getting strong. Of course, try to limit this chest fall pattern as much as you reasonably can. But you don't need to limit the loading to fix it. To a great extent, everybody exhibits this, especially when the weight gets heavy enough for them. So this is not uncommon. Yours is a bit dramatic compared to what it could be. So dramatic is maybe not my best choice of words there, but I hope you get what I'm getting at. It's something that you can improve, but it's not something that we need to, shut everything down on in order to improve it. So that's all I've got for you on the squat. Good luck.